بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أمسينا وأمسى الملك لله، والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. أمسينا على فطرة الإسلام وعلى كلمة الإخلاص وعلى دين نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم يا رب تقبل منا صلاتنا وصيامنا ودعاءنا وركوعنا وسجودنا. اللهم يا رب تقبل منا رمضان. اللهم تقبل منا رمضان. اللهم سلمنا لرمضان وسلم رمضان لنا وتسلمه منا متقبلا يا رب العالمين. Brothers and sisters, جزاكم الله خيرا for joining us and listening to this lecture, to this خاطرة before Maghrib. We ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to accept from us all. اللهم يا الله accept from us our صيام, our دعاء, our ركوع, our سجود. آمين يا رب العالمين. I'm going to talk about some gifts that Allah عز وجل granted us during Ramadan. Allah سبحانه وتعالى loves us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants khair for us. That's why He gave us and He blessed us with Ramadan. What do we have in Ramadan? Brothers and sisters, when some people look at Ramadan or fasting 30 days, some people they think, why we are fasting 30 days? Actually, we have many benefits from this siyam, from this month of Ramadan. Ramadan, it is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And usually, when someone give something or give something for someone else, that thing will be maybe good for that person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted us Ramadan. Allah has blessed us to have month of Ramadan, to fast. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. The purpose of Siyam, to have taqwa, which is the great level of Iman. To have to be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is great. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is helping us how to reach that level of Iman, how to have taqwa, how to be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And al-siyam, Jannah, al-siyam is protection. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us this kind of protection to protect ourselves because Allah loves us. That's why He gave us Ramadan, to protect our soul, our self from Jahannam, from haram, from our evil desires. Ramadan is very good chance to protect ourselves and to have that protection for entire year. That's why we have Ramadan only once a year. Because if someone fasted Ramadan well, perform Ramadan well, following the footsteps of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he will have that protection for entire his year. وَالصَّوْمُ جَنَّةٌ وَالصَّوْمُ جَنَّةٌ. And not only that, صَوْم after Ramadan, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam called the youth, called young men, if you are able to get married, so do so. If not, so fast, because fasting will help you to control yourself. Fasting will help you to control your eyes, to control your tongue, to control your ears, to control your feeling, to control your desires. Ramadan is very good. Not only Ramadan, any day, whenever you fast for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will protect you from Jahannam. And Allah will keep you away from Jahannam for 70 years, as we have many hadith talking about this. وَالصَّوْمُ نِصْفُ الصَّبْرِ. Because during Ramadan, during this great gift, this valuable gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will learn how to be patient, how to have sabr. How to have sabr. And sabr, we have different categories of sabr. Sabr to perform ibadah, sabr to avoid ma'asiyah, and sabr for some challenges, some difficulties that sometimes we face it in dunya. This is very important exercise, very important training that every mu'min, every believer should go through this training, through this course of Ramadan to have sabr, to be min al-sabirin. Number two, brothers and sisters, in Ramadan, Allah Azza wa Jal give us something else. Allah Azza wa Jal granted us the acceptance of dua. Allah will accept our dua. Allah yaqbalu minna ad-dua fi Ramadan. So accepting dua, it is something very important for us. All of us has many things, many questions, many requests from Allah. Ya Allah, accept us. Ya Allah, do we are doing well in this Ramadan? Are we doing well in this month or not? When we do dua, Ya Allah, accept from us. Ya Allah, be happy with us. Ya Allah, we are doing our best to please you. to perform عبادة will, to do صيام, to do صلاة, to do تراويح, to do سحور, and to avoid all haram stuff. Ya Allah, accept from us. This kind of dua, Allah will accept, inshallah. Allah will make it easy for you to perform that ibadah. Not only that, Prophet ﷺ mentioned that the fasting person, he has accepted dua from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will accept your dua while you are fasting. Not only that, some scholars said, when we start Ramadan, from the day one till the end of Ramadan, Allah will accept your dua, whether you are fasting or during night time. So whenever you do dua, whenever you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during suhoor, during tahajjud, before fajr, after fajr, at the breakfast time, when you break your fast, at that moment also you have dua will be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's very important, brothers and sisters, to use our time wisely during Ramadan to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, grant us success, happiness, forgiveness, mercy, peace, tranquility. Ya Allah, do whatever you want from dua. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whatever you want, and Allah will answer, and Allah will respond to your dua. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لِلصَّائِمِ عِنْدَ فِطْرِهِ دَعْوَةٌ لَا تُرَدْ. For the fasting person, he will have da'wah, accepted da'wah, when he breaks his fast. Like after a few minutes at the Maghrib time, let us raise our hands and to say, Ya Allah, accept. Ya Allah, grant us your forgiveness. Ya Allah, grant us your mercy. Always, brothers and sisters, we need to get ready for dua. We don't know what time Allah will accept. We don't know what the time of the doors of heavens, of the gates of heavens will be open for us. So let us ready. Let us get ready for that dua all the time. Remember yourself. Remember your parents. Remember your children. Remember your friends. Remember your family. Remember your relatives. Remember your community members. Remember your masjid. Remember your Islamic centers. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant you tawfiq, to grant you happiness, to grant you rahma and maghfira. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called us in Surah Al-Baqarah, after he mentioned the ayat of Siyam, if my servants, O Muhammad, if my servants ask you about me, where is our Lord? Should we call him loudly? Should we talk with him quietly? How can we call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. Tell them I'm very close to them. Allah, it is very beautiful, amazing ayah, amazing ayah. Allah Azza wa Jal is telling us he is very close to us and he is ready to accept our dua. He is ready to respond to our call. فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي. So let them respond to my call. Let them obey me. Let them worship me. فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يُرْشُدُونَ. Allah will guide us, inshallah. May Allah Azza wa Jal accept our dua. One of our scholars, التابعين, he said, I do dua in my sujood for more than 70 people by their names. I mention their names in my sujood. So when we remember our friends, our family members, our children, when we remember our spouses in our dua, Allah will accept. Why? Because when you do dua for your brother in his absence, there are angels. There is angel will say Ameen to your dua and you will have same. You have same. So that dua will be accepted from angel, from malaika. When we do dua for others, there is an angel asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our dua and to give us same that dua that we are asking for our friends. So this is number two, gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan, accepting dua. May Allah accept our dua. We have other gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during Ramadan. Do you know what is that that gift? You are practicing it every night after Isha, which is Salatul Taraweeh. Salatul Taraweeh is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whoever perform تراويح, perform قيام in Ramadan, Allah will forgive him all his sins. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, وأقم الصلاة طرفي النهار وزلفا من الليل إن الحسنات يذهبن السيئات ذلك ذكرى للذاكرين. When we perform salah, extra salah, that good deed will wipe the bad deed, will wipe our sins. Whenever we do good deed, Allah Azza wa Jalla will accept and Allah Azza wa Jalla will forgive our sins. إن الرجل إذا صلى مع الإمام حتى ينصرف حسب له قيام ليلة. Whenever a man performs salah, قيام الليل, تراويح with his imam, until imam finished his salah, his prayer, then the imam would leave the masjid, Allah will forgive all people inside masjid, those who follow their imam. Okay, so this is number three. Now, number four, which is very important for us, العتق من النار, freedom from hellfire, freedom from جهنم. يا الله أعتق رقابنا من النار يا رب العالمين. ولله عتقاء من النار وذلك كل ليلة. There are people, Allah will free them from جهنم every night during Ramadan. Every night during Ramadan, Allah will have group of people, of Muslimin, of Sa'imin. Allah will give them that freedom. You are free from جهنم. يا الله make us from those يا رب العالمين. يا الله أعتقنا من النار. يا الله أعتق رقابنا من النار برحمتك يا حنان يا منان يا ذا الجود والإحسان. اللهم أعتقنا من النار برحمتك يا حنان يا منان. And other hadith, Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, اتقوا النار ولو بشق تمرة. Protect yourself from جهنم even with half of like piece of date, tamr. If you have one piece of date or half date, protect yourself when you donate, when you give, when you support, when you help. Let us help each other. Brothers and sisters, month of Ramadan, month of giving, month of charity, month of zakah, month of sadaqat, month of happiness, month of mercy. Let us have mercy upon each other. Look around. You look for people around you, from your families, from your relatives, from your friends, from your community members. If your masjid in need, please support your masjid, support your Islamic center. It is time in Ramadan to support our masajid, the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to keep it open for our children, to keep it open for us to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to say la ilaha illallah, ahabbu al-biladi ila Allah fil ard, al-masajid. The best area in earth, the best places in earth, al-masajid, is al-masajid that Allah Azza wa Jalla created. Masajid to worship him subhanahu wa ta'ala, to obey him, to listen to Quran al-Karim, to listen to Khatira, to listen to Khutbat al-Jum'ah, to attend and participate in Khutbat al-Jum'ah. Ramadan, Shahru al-Itqi min al-Nar, protect ourselves from Jahannam by charity. And every one of us will come Yawm al-Qiyamah under the shade of his charity. So if you want to have good shade, you need to have good and strong shade Yawm al-Qiyamah. Let us go. Let us do, give charity and give more and more. And Allah will give us. And Allah will reward us. Wallahi, brothers and sisters, whenever we give, Allah will give. Ya Abdi, anfiq, unfiq alayk. Oh, my servant. This is a hadith Qudsi. My servant, when you spend, I will provide more. I will provide you more. Anfiq, unfiq alayk. Spend and I will give you. Spend and I will provide you. So do not hesitate to give fi sabilillah. And the last thing I would like to mention now before we go to a few ayat recitation from Quran al-Karim, inshallah, and the adhan at 7:51. The last thing I would like to mention now, the gift of Allah in Ramadan, Allah Azza wa Jal gave us opportunity to give iftar, sadaqah, which is also sadaqah, and iftar as-sa'imin, to give food, to share food with people. They will break their fast with your food, with your charity. So feeding, fasting Muslim, great opportunity during Ramadan. And we have brothers and sisters, wallahi, we have many people, they don't have food to break their fast. We have many brothers and sisters around the world. They don't have enough food to feed their families, to feed their children. It is our opportunity now to reach out to them through some organization, well-known organizations, and our IGH organization, mashallah, very, they are doing a great job with this side. May Allah bless them all. May Allah bless all our brothers and sisters, those are working behind the scene, working hard to reach out to all people in need, to give them and to share that happiness, to share your sadaqah with them. And we have many people around the world. You can reach them out. You can see them. You can contact them. You can communicate with them. And you can tell them, hey, this is my hadiyah, my gift to you, to enjoy your Ramadan, your iftar. They will do dua for you at that time. And Allah will accept their dua because they are doing dua for brother in his absence. من فطر صائما كان له مثل أجره غير أنه لا ينقص من أجر الصائم شيئا. Whoever offers food for a fasting one, fasting person, will gain a reward equal to the fasting person without reducing any reward from the fasting one. Wallah, it is great. This is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That generosity came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah wants us to understand well what the meaning of life. This is the meaning of our life, to understand and to give others. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you all, to grant you barakah in your life, to grant barakah in your food, your drink, your health, your wealth, your children. May Allah azza wa jal accept from us all. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. We'll have inshallah a few ayat recitations, then we'll do azan bi'ithnillahi ta'ala.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وسيق الذين كفروا إلى جهنم زمرا حتى إذا جاءوها فتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها ألم يأتكم رسل منكم يتلون عليكم آيات ربكم وينذرونكم لقاء يومكم هذا؟ قالوا بلى ولكن حق كلمة العذاب على الكافرين. قيل ادخلوا أبواب جهنم خالدين فيها فبئس مثوى المتكبرين. وسيق الذين اتقوا ربهم إلى الجنة زمرا حتى إذا جاءوها وفتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها سلام عليكم طبتم فادخلوها خالدين. وقالوا الحمد لله الذي صدقنا وعده وأورثنا الأرض نتبوأ من الجنة حيث نشاء فنعم أجر العاملين. وترى الملائكة حافين من حول العرش يسبحون بحمد ربهم وقضي بينهم بالحق وقيل الحمد لله رب العالمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. حم تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز العليم غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير. ما يجادل في آيات الله إلا الذين كفروا فلا يغررك تقلبهم في البلاد. كذبت قبلهم قوم نوح والأحزاب من بعدهم، وهمت كل أمة برسولهم ليأخذوه، وجادلوا بالباطل ليدحضوا به الحق فأخذتهم، فكيف كان عقاب؟ وكذلك حقت كلمة ربك على الذين كفروا أنهم أصحاب النار الذين يحملون العرش ومن حوله يسبحون بحمد ربهم ويؤمنون به ويستغفرون للذين آمنوا ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة وعلما فاغفر للذين تابوا واتبعوا سبيلك وقهم عذاب الجحيم. ربنا وأدخلهم جنات عدن التي وعدتهم ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم، إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم. وقهم السيئات، ومن تق السيئات يومئذ فقد رحمته، وذلك هو الفوز العظيم. إن الذين كفروا ينادون لمقت الله أكبر من مقتكم أنفسكم إذ تدعون إلى الإيمان فتكفرون. قالوا ربنا أمتنا اثنتين وأحييتنا اثنتين فاعترفنا بذنوبنا، فهل إلى خروج من سبيل؟ ذلكم بأنه إذا دعي الله وحده كفرتم، وإن يشرك به تؤمنوا، فالحكم لله العلي الكبير.
صدق الله العظيم، جزاك الله خيرا محمد. May Allah accept inshallah ta'ala. We'll do adhan inshallah right now. It is time to do adhan.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.